So today, of course, is a body type video, shocker, but we're gonna talk about three ways you can identify your body type if you're struggling to figure out what it is, or if you feel like the way you look doesn't necessarily match what actually happens with your body. So let's figure that out. So I'm gonna assume everyone watching this video is probably over the age of 20. So what you can do is go back, find some pictures, or remember if you don't have a lot of pictures, and figure out what you look like between the ages of 12 and about 17, when all the major hormone changes happen, when puberty hits, when you start to lose the original baby fat you may have had, or just when your body starts to kind of level out until its natural state. And most of the time, for most people, that's between the ages of 12 and 17. So go back and look at those pictures and then reference old videos as to what certain body types look like aesthetically, and that could help you out. Because now you could be older, life happens, bad dieting, not consistent in the gym, and you may look a little bit different than you did between those ages. So figure out what you look like between 12 and 17. Okay, so number two, you found the pictures, you looked at the pictures, and you still can't tell what's going on. Cool, perfect. Number two is think about how you feel after certain workouts. So we're gonna break this down into cardio, weights, and mix or interval HIIT style training, right? So let's start with cardio. So if you go for long runs and you feel like your joints are hurting after your long duration runs, like a jog at the park, a mile on the treadmill, something like that. If you find that your joints, your back, your knees, your ankles are kind of bothering you, you're more than likely one of the blend types, ectomeso blend or endomeso blend, or you're an ectomorph, all right? So you're one of those three types if your joints kind of hurt when you do long duration style cardio. If you notice that sprints and high power cardio feels good to you, like sprinting up the hill, jumping on the box, slamming ropes, throwing balls around, if you like that stuff, then you belong to the same group because that's kind of how you're built. If you notice that the high intensity type cardio output activities kind of tire you out or that hurts, then you're probably on the endo side of things, or you could be a mesomorph that just goes really hard. Okay, now let's talk about weights. So if you notice that you're really strong in the gym, lifting weights comes natural to you, the amount of weight that you put on seems to kind of be just in flow with the workout. You're not really having to adjust a whole lot. You're good with power reps. You're also good with volume reps. You're probably right in the middle with meso, okay? If you notice that you're not super strong in the gym naturally, but you can handle a lot of volume, you more than likely belong to the strict ecto, solid ecto, or solid endo types, all right? Now, if you notice that you're pretty strong, all right, you can handle the volume and you can handle the power, but when it comes to power, you kind of get fatigued a little bit, and then when it comes to volume, it kind of hurts when you do a lot because you don't really feel it unless you're picking up a certain weight and everything kind of feels confusing. That's because you're a blend type. And blend types, again, they have those tapered muscles, the short muscle bellies and everything. So you're actually built for power output, but at the same time, you don't have a lot of meat and girth in one area to really handle a lot of load, even though you are still pretty strong. So if you notice that you kind of feel all over the place in the weight room, but you're still comfortable with picking up weights and you enjoy it, you're probably a blend type. Okay, last one, let's talk about cardio as it relates to HIIT training or Tabata training or interval training, or you know, 30 on, 15 off, 20 on, 10 off, stuff like that, or most group exercise classes, right? So if you go to like group classes, like this is the type of training that I'm talking about. So if throwing a med ball and then doing a sprint and then running back and then falling to the ground and then rolling around and all of that type of stuff is what I'm referring to. If these things don't really bother you at all, or, you know, whatever, just kind of whatever, mesomorph for sure. If you naturally enjoy these things, okay, then you belong to one of the endo types, which is going to be a strict endo or the endo-meso blend, which long duration plus a little bit of intensity is wonderful, okay? So now let's talk about the ecto types when it comes to high intensity interval training. Strict ecto. For high intensity interval training, you're probably not gonna like it because it's gonna hurt because you don't have a whole lot of cushion, you know, to catch and absorb impact the way some of the naturally thicker and girthier types do. So when it comes to like group exercise classes and running around and jumping around and falling down and getting back up and shit like that, you're probably gonna be upset and you'd rather not do that shit because it kind of hurt a little bit on the cool. Okay, if you are a blend type, you will be good at these things, but you will still hurt the same way that the strict meso type does. So if you're an ecto meso, when it comes to jumping around and moving around, when people see you do it, they'll be like, oh, like that guy's a beast, like he can really handle this. But internally, you will be in pain the same way the ecto is, because it's kind of a split to where you have the meso working in your favor to where those things look great and they are highly performed on the surface, but the ecto part of you is still in pain the way that the ecto is in pain. So remember that. Feel free to rewind all of that and take notes, because I know that was a lot to try to remember off the dome, okay? But let's get into the last point, which is really my favorite point and the easiest one for people, especially if you're over the age of 20 and you've kind of moved out of that natural range to where you're in the space to where you have to maintain and sustain what you do, and like your habits kind of start to catch up with you, positive or negative, just depends, it's case by case. But what I like to tell people or ask them when they're trying to self-assess their body type is pay attention to and think about what your body does when you're not on a strict diet or workout program, and that will tell you where your natural state is. So we'll go start to finish. If you are a strict ectomorph, when you're not hardcore on your nutrition and your weightlifting program, you'll just get naturally skinny. But with the strict ecto, it's important to remember that you're going to start to shrink or shrivel or get slim, whatever word you want to use. You're going to start to see that evenly from head to toe, okay? When you're not hard on your diet and your workout regimen. Moving into the ecto meso, when you are not hard or strict or concentrated on your workout diet and your exercise regimen, you'll start to get smaller like the ecto, but you'll start to get smaller in areas, all right? So you'll start to kind of look a little bad built. Like when you're hardcore, your shoulders are popping, your chest is sitting upright. When you're not on it, it's like the chest kind of stayed, but my forearms are looking skinny. Like my thighs kind of stayed, but my calves look weak. Like you'll start to notice, like, I think I'm still kind of muscular, but for some reason, I just look bad built and I don't know why. And that's because when you fall off, because you're a blend type, just like the endo-meso blend type, you start to kind of look bad built, but just in certain areas, so it's not all even. Meso, strict meso, when you fall off, you know what's up. You just look like whatever it is you are doing. So mesotypes will tend to maintain, or they'll kind of just be leveled out based on what they're doing. So if you're not hardcore lifting weights, if you're not hardcore in your diet regimen, and you're just kind of living life, but you're not really overeating and you're just kind of existing, you'll look like that because you kind of have that natural frame to where you may not be super shredded or toned or cut, but you'll still maintain your natural body shape and physique for the most part. It just won't really be as defined, all right? But again, you know the mantra for the strict meso, you are how you live, so If you're not strict and you start eating a lot, you can get fat. If you're doing a whole bunch of, you know, vegan type diet regimen or doing a lot of, you know, cardio or something like that, or just playing more recreational sports, you can get a little smaller, but all in all, you'll still maintain a pretty even balanced frame. Endomeso, okay, so similar to the ectomeso, you are a blend type, all right, but you are a endomeso, which means that you have the endo component of naturally gaining weight and holding more girth without having to really do a whole lot, and you have the meso, which gives you that nice balanced frame, but when you fall off, you start to gain weight in specific areas and not evenly, okay? So the strict ecto, they lose weight evenly, and the strict endo, they gain weight evenly, but the endomeso, you gain weight in spots, okay? So similar to the ectomeso blend who loses weight in spots, you're going to start gaining weight in spots, which could cause you to have a nice balanced frame, but you got a pot belly, or your neck starts to look chunky and you're trying to figure out why, or you're just holding just a lot of girth, like right on top of your butt area or like in your calves somehow. You're trying to figure that shit out. Like, why am I, again, looking bad built, but only in certain areas? Like, it don't make sense, but you can't change it, man. That's genetics. Endo, when you fall off, you're gonna blow up all over. Keep it straightforward and simple. When you fall off, you're going to get big all over. But I don't really see that as a bad thing. I kind of wish I had some of that. Being an ectomeso, I'm falling off and I'm looking bad built. I know endomesos feel the same thing. Like, man, why I gotta look bad built? At least the endos can gain the weight evenly and still look good in their clothes and not look goofy. Like, the blend types always look goofy. I hate it, man. But anyway, endo, beware, gain weight from head to toe, water weight, additional fat. Of course, we all hate it, but in those two, just maintain your consistency, keep up your walks, keep up your moderate exercise, and you should be good to keep a lot of that water weight off. That's all we got for today. Hope this video helps somebody. Subscribe, share, leave a comment, do all the things. Y'all know what to do. See y'all next time. Peace.